Well, this is Baruch Fleischman here at the Tikkun Elevator Kolel, and as we're about to get on page Shin Nun in Parshas Bo, reading the Zohar on the Parshas of the week, this is the third day, the day of Tiferet. Now, before we get into the issue of Iyuv and all the things that we've been talking about, let's look in one more time a little bit about Shovavim, something I want to learn about. So we said that before that Shovavim is a period of 6 to 8 weeks, particularly during this period of time, starting with Parshas Shmos, and in this leap year, it's going to go all the way through Parshas Tetzaveh. It's a time of reflection on sexual aveiras. Let's just say it out the way that it is. Sex is probably the most powerful force that exists in the world because it's the force of creation. People misuse it, has been terribly, terribly abused and misused. So over here during this period of time, which is the time of Awisi, of Dinim, if you're an astrologer, then you understand that Tevis is a sign. Tevis and Shvat are signs of what they call Saturnian signs of darkness and cold. This is the winter. This is the darkest time of the year. This is the time to reflect on our dark days as well. So it says, during these 3 weeks, it is customary, we're reading right here, to be more careful not to violate any of the sexually related transgressions commanded in the Torah. Some have the customs of studying laws relating to such transgressions, let's say, for example, and they also fast, and they give maybe extra tzedakah during this time. They also spend some time reciting Selichos, and there are other different kinds of tikkunim, which I'm not particularly I am not familiar with, designed to counteract their harmful effects. On the Shabbos, when these weekly portions of the Torah are read, some take upon themselves an idea that we want to mention, to refrain from speaking. It's only words of prayer and Torah, that's it. This type of fast is called a tainus dibur. Something to think about has to do with this time of year. Now, let's go over to the Zohar here. And our Zohar, make sure I got some not so bad. So he says the screen is not so bad. So we're going to come over here and talk about Job, about Eve. And I said that personally, at least this little bit, I think you could take this Zohar very personally. If I look at my own background, because my family came here so many years ago, there's very little left of my family that is Jewish anymore, or they know they're Jewish, but they're not involved, they're gone. So here I am as a remnant. So if you think of my background, of where I'm coming from, if a Kodesh Baruch Hu of the Satan, let's say, want to come before a Kodesh Baruch Hu and say, over here, Baruch, look at him, he says now he wants to learn sod. He wants to be so close to you, but look who he is. Look where he comes from. He's no yichus. He's nobody. So this is the same thing about the Jewish people. We were mixed in. I was not like that too. Mixed in with the Gentiles, going to Gentile schools, eating Gentile food, living the Gentile life until I figured out I was Jewish. Okay, that's great. But by the same token, this kind of problem always develops, and there are accusations. And what did HaKadosh Baruch Hu do? He gave the Sultan Iyuv to torture. Why? And the Zohar says, because Iyuv gave that same advice to Paro in regards to the Jewish people. So Iyuv, on the other hand, he has a taina as well. So here's where we're at right now, that Iyuv, in fact, is in the process of being punished, and if you start reading through Iyuv, so this is Zohar is giving us a background on this idea. So the Zohar says like this, Tochazik Amitzi Maksiv, what is written over here. So he says, we'll quote, Keshemasar HaKodesh Baruch Hu as Iyuv biyad HaSatan. Now, HaKodesh Baruch Hu has given Iyuv into the hands of the Satan. The Satan has now turned his back on the Jewish people, on the children of Israel, who are going to go through the Yam Suf and into etc., but not Iyuv. V'yomer Hashem al HaSatan. Hashem said to the Satan, Ak es nafsho shamor, but guard his soul. Shelo teitze nafsho megodol yisurim, that he shouldn't lose his life as a result of the punishment that you're giving him. V'yisihiv le'rushus l'mishlot al bisra. and the Kodesh Baruch Hu gave him permission to have control over his flesh. So now the Matok says it's two different things. Maybe it's the same on his flesh and on his body. So we begin Raza Dixiv in this. The whole reason for this is because of this secret. Kate's called Bazar Baldafona. Now this is an interesting idea, and I don't know exactly what to do with it, but he says the end of all Bazar has come before me. So he says, who is the end of all Bazar? Because apparently it has a name attached to Lukumuhu, and it's explained like this. Shahasat, and the Satan itself is called the Kate's called Bazar. That's his name. The end of all flesh. Why? The fi she'oise kates, because he makes an end, a finish, a sof, and an ending. The call bosser, ayide kitrogo. In other words, he can kill whoever he wants by accusation. Maybe it also means that none of us leave the world without being judged. So maybe that's what it means too. I'm not sure. Hu ba lefonai vadai. So he actually has come before me. That is lahastin. Aldor Hamabel. So that particular quote was brought from the criticism, the attack, the accusation of the Dor Hamabel, Kedei Lekabel Rishus Lekalosim, in order to be able to receive permission to destroy them. So we see here that the Sultan has the power of destruction. He's the Kates Kalbasar. But at the same token, he needs a permission from a Kodesh Baruch Hu because he's an agent. But understand that it says at the end of all flesh, physicality, velo rucha, but not spirit. Because the Shal Satan really has no capacity, no ability to control our spirits. And now we want to say that he is the end that comes from the side of darkness. Well, the man, the Shechel Satan, who are Kates, he's the end, he's the finish. Of Baum Mitzad HaChoshek, from the tide of blackness, darkness. The Hainu Mesigi HaGavuros, that is, from the leftovers, the unusable portions of the Gavuros, which are Kadosh. HaNekros HaChoshek, so that those Sigim are called darkness. Kamed HaAtom, like you might say like this, Kates Sam LaChoshek, he made an end to darkness. Now, what does that mean? We've got a different translation. HaKodesh Baruch Hu bara es ha-satan. HaKodesh Baruch Hu created the satan. Shuhu ha-shaliach, who is his emissary. HaKotzes v'kores es ha-mitzchayim b'din. He cuts off those people. In other words, he makes an end to them. Of those people who are guilty in din v'sam al tzad ha-choshech. And he puts them on the side of darkness. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean to me that he kills them. It could mean that a person gets into a life cycle that is really dark. Now, in all of the goals of a person, the Satan investigates. Pirush. That is all flesh. Because the body, let's understand, the body has something it wants to do. It's at the go place, it has goals, but also only lives for a certain amount of time. The Kosh Baruch Hu looks at human beings and tries to figure out when is this person going to end. That person, in other words, he's sitting and waiting for this person to be given over into his hand. Begin the is Kates Achram. Now he says why the Kates called Basar is an idea. We have to understand it applies to the Satan, but on the other hand, we have another phrase which it says the Kates. Where is it? Begin the Ihu Kates Achra. There's another one, which is Ikri Kates Hayomim, which is called the end of days. The Vishyach Kates Achra, because there's another end. Hanikra Kates Hayomim, which is called the end of days. Shuha Malchus is also the Malchus of Kedusha. Now, Malchus of Kedusha is called the end of the days because the 6 days of the week, which are Chesed, Gevurah, Tiferes, Netzach, Hod, and Yesod, which, of course, we're going through this every week now. She's the end of them. In other words, they all pour into her. She's the bottom of the, she's the end of the line. So Shabon Ne'echazet, because on her, Ne'echazet Nefashas for Ruchos, because these lights, which represent the energy of the Nefesh and the Ruach of the Tzaddikim, Val Yado Mekabdim Sechar, they are all attached to this Malchus. So therefore, from her, they get the reward, and therefore, she's the Kates. That's the reward that they get at the end of their cycle, which goes from Chesed to through Yisod. But the one we're talking about now is a different case. It's the case that comes from the side of the left, the side of the left and the side of Din. It comes from the left side, which is darkness. Because it is through this case, that left side case, where people are punished. So therefore, Hakadosh Baruch Hu gave to the Sultan Rishus to have control over himself and over, let's see what Atzmo means, but it says over and his flesh. To strike Iyuv, to wound Iyuv. Begufo, Bisaro in his body, because he means internally, and Bisaro in his outside, below Benafsha, but not on his soul, not spiritually. Kamasha Kosev is written like this, as Nafsho Shamor, that he guarded his soul. So let's come over here and let's see the bottom. Masha Amar Kodesh Baruch LaSatan. Now what we see that the Kodesh Baruch, here is a Pasuk, and I want to read, let me just see if I can dig it out. Might have made a mistake here and not marked the place for it. That's Isaiah. Where's Job? Here's Job back here. And I think that we're in the early part of Job here. And so let's see. One moment. I gotta find this. Now let me move this into position. And this is a pasuk that contains the Taina, the claim of Job. This is the introduction to it, and this is number 3. And as you see, we are in the art scroll. Hashem asks the Satan, did you set your heart to take note of my servant Job? For there's no one like him on earth. I assume that the Kodesh Baruch Hu is speaking to the Satan. A wholesome and upright man who fears God and shuns evil. All of these things are true. And he still maintains his wholesomeness. You incited me against him to destroy him for no reason. Now, that's a statement that Kodesh Baruch Hu is making as a possibility to the Sultan. So let's see what this says now. He said, "For Masha Amar Kodesh Baruch Hu LaSatan V'Tasi Seini Bo Levalo, that you enticed me or tested me or forced me to create this test to destroy him. That you accused or made accusations of love, and you tested me or you pushed me in this direction, to destroy him for nothing, with no sin at all. That's what you were trying to do, right? Just to test him. But it's a problem. If HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave Iyuv over to the Sultan, just the test of Iyuv, to see what he could do, because he's a righteous man, right? But if that's the case, it wasn't right. There's no reason why Iyuv to be punished. But according to what he's saying, that is the words of the Maktarik, they're the person, the accuser, which is the Sultan. Shehasisa HaKadosh Baruch Hu, who really sort of like caused the Kodesh Baruch Hu to create this test for Vahita also, and he got him to do it. So how is it that you could say that he was punished by, according to that Mida, because the Mida that he said over there by Mitzrayim. Now, I think that what he's saying, I'm not really sure what he said before, is that actually he's saying that the Kodesh Baruch Hu was tricked or seduced into allowing this arrangement to come about. See, but we had said that he's being punished because of the fact that he advised Paro to punish the Jews. The Mataritz Elukulu Bedinahavu. So the Zohar answers that this was all done properly. V'hochi Amar lo Elihu. So Iyuv's friend Elihu, he made the statement. K'shetan Iyuv, because Iyuv came, and Iyuv claimed that he's being punished for nothing. Al hinam. Amalo, so he said to him, that is his friend Eliu, ki poil adam yishalim lo. What a person does in this world, kafi masha poil adam, according to the deeds that a person commits, ken yishalim lo, those will be paid back to him. By Hakadosh Baruch Hu im tov im ra, if he did good things or if he did bad things. Let me see if I can lower this light a little bit. And then the rest of the pasuk, and in the way of the man, you'll find, that's where you'll find him, in the way of the man's deeds, he means. So according to the path that a person manages in life, came Yamsiyalo Hakadosh Baruch Hu Onsho Scharos, so then Hakadosh Baruch Hu will prepare and will, he will find along the way his punishment or his reward. V'hochi Ava Kama De Itmar, and this is really the way that it was as it stated. Kama De Ihu Gzar Chochi is Gzar Ale. The same kind of decrees that he made, which he made on the Jewish people, will be made back on him. He said, so let's go over these words again. He says, and you caused me to create this test on him, labalo chinum, in order to swallow him up or destroy him for nothing. That was the claim of Iyuv. Shemashba shakodesh baruch hu, that's mashba, implies that akodesh baruch hu, kaviyachol nises mal satan, what he's doing, he's getting this idea of making a test. He got that from the satan. Limsor es Iyuv biyado, in order to give Iyuv into the hands of the satan, bechinum, velo avon. He did it for nothing, just, he said before, just to save the Jews. Why? So what? Why? But he said, not good enough. Enoch b'shuta, this is, so the Matok answers, he says, this is not the simple meaning. Shasatan hesis is a Kodesh Baruch Hu, that somehow, Kodesh, that Satan, he seduced the Kodesh Baruch Hu to do what he wanted. It's because it says, look at the Zohar, he says, ketatsiseni lebalo lo kasif. The Pasuk doesn't say that he seduced me or he caused me to make, this is really what I think it means, he caused me to make a test, the test that he couldn't stand up to and it would destroy him. That's not what's written. But what is written actually, Ella, and you have to look at this case, this carefully, Ella tasiseni bo, on him. Verotzalomer, and it means to say like this, that he caused me to create this test on him. Ki bei kaima bedate. Besevaris Iyuv ala kach bedato. So it means to say that the Kodesh Baruch Hu, he knew what Iyuv was going to say. Dihu chashiv tachatis yisaini, because he thought that he's just being tested. I've heard this many times from people, people get themselves back together again, people who had money lost it, people who had health lost it, people who are younger, and really, we're going to come out of it, but nonetheless, the depression takes place. And so the Iku Chashiv Dehot is saying it, because then he starts thinking, people start thinking, Hashem is just testing me. That's it. He's testing me. Shuhu Chashiv She'enu Nisisani V'nispata D'mincho. Excuse me. Shuhi Chashiv She'ani Nisasi. I tested him. V'nispata D'mincho. And I was seduced from you, O holy Satan. Come to Amar, like you say, like this. Va'al atzas rishayim hofato. Mira, meaning what? The advice of Satan. He says, Shepirusho, Amro Iyos, his patati al meimer dahaku mektarga. That all you did, you started to test me because ayidei Divrei HaSatan, and you did this because of the words the Satan said, as atzatzo l'hashdineni, l'hashkiseni himan, in order to destroy me for nothing. And the Zohar concludes here, and it says, Kagav Nadoav, just like this situation, Zech Siv, it's written like this, V'yifatechu b'picho v'lushona yichaz v'lo. They seduced them with their mouths, and with their tongues, they lied about it. Kisham Kasha. I mean, let's ask this question. The Satan, is it possible that Iyuv could say the Satan is making a mistake because he'd been blinded by the Satan? Once again, the Kodesh Baruch Hu had been blinded by the Satan. Elo Eilek B'Shuda, but that's not really what it means. He said, "Ki v'yifatuchu v'yichazvuchu v'lo loksiv." It doesn't say that they seduced him and then they lied about him. That's not what's written. Ela v'yipatuchu b'pihem. But they seduced him with their mouths. What does that mean? Shepirushu b'pihem. That's the accusation. Shebepichem kaimach mila da. Da is pata. Heim amro bepichem shachakodesh baruch hu nispata. So they were said by themselves, their own say, that the Kodesh Baruch Hu was seduced or tricked. Ava be'emesenu kein. So people can say that. That's all what it is in their mouths saying that. Kamo kein be'iyuv. So the same thing by Iyuv. Hu chashev shachakodesh baruch hu nises bedivir satan. So he is thinking, he's tining, he's making this claim that the Kodesh Baruch Hu was really tested by a satan, and he decided that he was going to go this way and punish me for nothing. But the truth is not like that. But in fact, he was judged according to what he had coming to him. This is Baruch Fleischman at the Tikkun Elevator Kollel. This is the third day of Parshas Bo. Kol Tov.